heard of ARFID. It's getting a lot of attention in the news lately, avoidant restrictive food intake disorder, and you don't know quite enough about it. Here are five things you might need to know about ARFID. One, there are three subtypes of ARFID, and you can all can be present or just one. There's food avoidance, where kids or adults are just avoiding food, have no appetite. Sensory dependent, they're avoiding food based upon texture, taste, consistency, and fear of adverse consequences. So maybe they've had a choking incident or something bad happened with food, or they're worried something bad's gonna happen about food. Those are the three subtypes. Two, adults can have ARFID. We find that we actually are seeing adults, male and female, into college age or further who struggle with ARFID. What we're actually finding third is that 14% of patients coming into treatment centers have ARFID and 30% of them are male. Also, what we're finding is that often families and patients are seeking treatment around the age of 12. Fourth, you don't have to be underweight to struggle with ARFID. Patients and families may not know that because sometimes kids are coming in with a normal weight and still struggling. But for the families and kids who do come in underweight, often those patients know they're underweight and actually want to gain weight, which is different than other eating disorders. And fifth, progress is going to look a lot different for somebody with ARFID over another diagnosis. Oftentimes it's slower and may not mean full return to all fruits and vegetables or all food groups. It's going to be really individualized to those clients. Any of these sound familiar or sound like they might apply to your child, we highly recommend that you follow up with your child's primary care physician to ensure that these questions are answered for you and that next steps can be taken.